GOAT right now in the WNBA is without question Breonna Stewart. Mike, you think about some people, everywhere they go, everything they touch, it's just going to be successful. It is so much fun to watch Breonna Stewart doing her thing, and she's been doing it her entire career, her entire basketball playing life. She's been a winner. Go ahead, do that thing. Go with that champagne. I need some champagne. Oh, give me some champagne too, Breonna.
I think the kids say she was a whole mood last night. I think that's what they say. She was a whole mood chugging champagne with her goggles on. She said there's alcohol in the wobble. That's how we're celebrating tonight. More, listen, okay, I don't want to steal your thunder. I don't want to stop your flow. This is the last 8 years. This is the last 8 years.
Take it. Because that's where I'm going.
Gatorade National
Where you're
Player
going is where
year.
I was going. Yep.
Gatorade National Player of the Year. Four-time NCAA champ. Three-time NCAA Player of the Year. Four-time NCAA Tournament Most Outstanding Player. A FIBA gold medal. A FIBA World Cup MVP. EuroLeague regular season MVP. WNBA Rookie of the Year. Two-time All-WNBA First Team. Two-time WNBA All-Star. Two-time WNBA MVP second this year. I'll be back to that in a second. Two-time WNBA champ. And two-time WNBA Finals MVP, all by the age of 26. This run was interrupted by a blown Achilles, which cost her all of last season, only to come back this season to average damn near 20-8 and finish second in MVP and win a championship again. I mean, she's 26. Let's just stay there for a second. She's 26. She's young enough to be both of our daughters. That's how old we are. But the point is, she's just getting started. Where is she going to take this thing, Michael Holly?
I don't know where she's going to take it. I don't know how much further can she go. I'm not really sure. I mean, you talk about that four-time finals, four-time NCAA champion, and four times most outstanding player in the NCAA tournament. So that's crazy in itself. But, I love the dynamic. There's so many things I love about this story. I really could talk about it all day long. I love the connection. Sue Bird, who's 40.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With Breonna Stewart, who's 26. And they both went to UConn. And I had the pleasure of watching, being where we are, this part of the country, you get to see UConn basketball. And if you haven't had a chance, to watch them do their thing, it's amazing. It's amazing what Gino Auriemma has done with that program. And it's not just the winning. Like, from afar, you could just look at it and say, oh, of course, he just gets the best players in the country and rolls the ball out there. But their teams are so different. Like, Breonna Stewart's team was different than Sue Bird's team. Sue Bird's team was just, like, so surgical, so smart.
Right.
Like, it was a reflection of her. It was Sue Bird's team. And Breonna Stewart, her game, she's got an inside and outside game, so that team kind of followed her lead. And also, Mike, the other thing I like about this is just how far we've come in the women's game, not only at the college level, but at the WNBA level, too. You know, the first UConn team I actually followed closely was the 1995 team that was undefeated. That was Rebecca Lobo was on that team, my cousin. Nikesha Sales was on that team. Shout out. But anyway, they had a really good team. They were undefeated, national champs. But after that, there's nowhere to go because the WNBA didn't exist at that time. It was a couple more years before the WNBA started. So now I like it that you can have one level, one type of women's basketball at the collegiate level, and then something else in the pros.
Well, it's not just that. I mean, look at the program right now. You're talking about a golden age when it comes to these young stars. I mean, you know, Sabrina Ionescu, you know, just came into the league. I know she got hurt this year, but I mean, there's so many young, you know, Asia Wilson, obviously coming up short in the finals, not individually, but her team coming up short in the finals.
Yeah.
Just won MVP. I mean, it's a great time for the women's game right now, especially coming off the gains that the women's game made, long overdue gains that they made in the collective bargaining agreement. But no, I thought you were going to talk about the connection between Sue and Breonna Stewart. Sue probably won the... So there's this internet thing going now I think our handle, I think Kwani got even got in on it on our handle, like how it started or how it's going or how it started and how it ended. Yeah. Sue nailed it. I mean, that's how you do it. That's how far apart in age they are. I mean, let's show some love to Sue Bird, who had 16 assists the other day. 40 years old. Her fourth championship coming, I think 16, is it 16 years after her first, I believe it is.
Right.
Storm tying the record for most championships in WNBA history. You know, I mean, that was the story last night. I mean, look, the Lakers did their thing, but the bigger story was the continued brilliance of Breanna Stewart, because it's like, could she go down as the most decorated player? Like, let's mix genders here for a second, if you don't mind.
Go ahead. Yes.
We have the GOAT conversation in the NBA. People talk about Kareem. And one of the arguments for Kareem, there are many, one of the arguments for Kareem is his resume going back to Power Memorial, okay? And up through high school, college at UCLA, and of course what he did in the NBA. I mean, Breanna Stewart and the resume and the run that she's on with no sign of slowing down, I'm not saying it's the same thing. But when you just want to talk about sheer brilliance and dominance in your team sport, she may put the resume conversation out of reach. You know, I mean, she is Katie Ledeckying the field when it comes to lapping her competition in women's basketball.
And I think based on what we know, based on what we have in front of us, there's no argument. But just like in the NFL when we talk about, or basketball when we talk about block shots, or in the NFL when we talk about sacks, there's a period where they started keeping the stats.
So yeah, 82, for sacks, yeah, right?
Yeah, so yeah. Sacks, and they start keeping a stat. But there were many sack masters before then that didn't
Deacon
get credit
Jones
for it.
Deacon Jones probably got the record. We just don't know it.
Same thing with block shots. Okay, there are a lot of people doing it, but didn't get credit for it.
That's Bill Russell's record. We all know it's Russell's record.
Right.
Exactly.
So in the the WNBA, this is like we got 22 years in to the WNBA. So you think about some great ballers. And the 70s.
Who didn't get the chance to do that, right?
And even
Cheryl
early
Miller's
90s.
Of the world. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Who didn't get a chance to play. And there were professional leagues out there, but there was not a professional league that was running parallel with the with the NBA.
That's a great point.
And so it's hard to see it.
That's a great point.
What we know right now.
They can't put that resume up against hers because the jobs weren't there. The job opportunities weren't there. Let's put it that way. But it's just, you're right. Let's just bask in her brilliance, man, and just watch somebody who's just at every opportunity. Look, she's 47-5. Her teams are in her postseason career, won their last 10 playoff games. I mean, she's automatic. And not even an Achilles could slow her down. Hey, man, we rolling. Let's take this break right fast. We got to get into this debate. There's no look passes we making. We don't need script. We don't need a script.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.